Hello, my name is Neo. I'm the founder of this project, which is Huertos Evergreen. This is Huertos Evergreen, which means evergreen gardens. Welcome to the Huerto. We first started talking about this project in February of 2021, and we laid our first foundation in July of the same year. And ever since, we've been working hard to put together a project where we can produce organic produce locally in this urban market garden. I came to Mexico in the first part of 2021. I had just finished my master's degree in international agricultural development from UC Davis. And I couldn't have been more excited to put my knowledge to work in a practical way. So here we are trying to put the latest practices for agriculture into motion, as well as learning from the locals who have taught me a lot about how to plant things and what grows during which seasons in this part. And so it's been both a teaching and a learning experience. And that's how I think life should be. We should always be learners as long as we can, and then teach others what we know. I'm here working with a couple of other people. I have one other employee who's part-time, and then I also have a number of contract workers who have done a lot of the different projects around here. And so it's been a great experience with a lot of support from family and friends. And so it's always rewarding to be really building something for the entire community that everyone can be proud of. Here's our little ducks. We have four ducks, three males and one female. And right behind is their little duck house. Here it is. Casita de Patos. Custom built duck house just for them, and everyone said I went too far with this, but we love our ducks here. So here's our front door. Comes down like a little ramp, and that's where they live inside. This property started out as nothing more than an abandoned lot. It was full of rocks and garbage. And after months of work, a lot of work, we were able to clean this place up. So these are our permanent crops. First we have here a fig tree. And then we have our first set of rosemary. There's a bougainvillea behind, which is a flower. Flowering bush. Then we have our pomegranate right here. Look, it's already putting out some nice flowers. In the back is amaranth. We have some cactuses. Also behind here we have a a row of corn, which is looking really nice right now. Blue agave, this is the kind that they make tequila out of. So it's our Mexican touch here. Guayaba, or guava, you would say. Freshly seeded chamomile. Basil. This is like a field of basil, basically, and we have two of those. And in the middle is our avocado, our Haas avocado tree. We have two main things that we're doing here. One of them is we have chickens. They're laying hens of the Rhode Island Red breed. And those are going to be for our organic egg production. And then we also have organic vegetables section. We have grown everything from onions to tomatoes to prickly pear cactus, which is popular here in Mexico. We also have alfalfa, so we can feed our animals and also sell what is extra. Tomato, we have tomatillo, spinach, radish. Here's our onions. We have some black beans, some eggplant, calendula over there. Over there is zucchini. And then over here we have a combination of corn and beans, like the ancestral way of planting corn and beans was together, so that they can complement each other. Zucchinis, which is cultivated for its flower and its fruit. So here's the zucchini flower, and it's really popular to put this flower in quesadillas and other foods. So it's part of the diet here. And as you can see, everything is over here is on drip irrigation. So all we have to do is open the valve right here. And we can water our bed without any effort. It also saves water because you can apply exactly the amount that you need. Over here we have our popcorn. This is La Granja, or the animal farm. So let's go ahead and see what's going on back here. So these are our chickens. These are the Rhode Island Red chickens. And some of them are even a little bit black color, you can see. And these are our turkeys. Okay, and over here is our chicken coop. We're located in Chimalhuacan, Mexico, in the state of Mexico, which is an urbanized area and a lot of hungry mouths to feed, but not a lot of production anymore. This area used to be an agricultural zone with a lot of water, a lot of production of everything you can eat. And unfortunately, overpopulation has ended the golden age of agricultural production here. So we hope that this project is going to bring back a little bit of that. We're kind of re-greening one of the spaces that was lost. Actually, this land that we're standing on now was very productive and fertile land for farming. They grew corn here and a lot of other crops.
Yo soy Ofelia Castillo Valentino. Yo nacida en Chimalhuacán. Y aquí fue mi niñez. Y aquí ya estoy viejita. Ah, cuando era yo pequeña, venía yo a jugar a este lugar. Estaba bonito, había cerro. Mi mamá tuvo mucho pato. Mi papá sembró mucho maíz y tuvo mucha abundancia de maíz. Ah, sí, aquí estuvo el lago de Texcoco. Y todo eso lo vivimos. También había patos. Había muchos animales así raros. Pero fue muy bonito la laguna.
And now it's mostly apartments and houses. And so it's my dream to see this place be productive again as a agricultural space, but one with new techniques, with better appreciation for nature. Everything here is organic. We have never put any kind of synthetic chemicals on anything. We use organic compost for fertility. We have sheep manure. We also fertigate, that's irrigation with fertilizer using water from our duck pond. And we also have composting worms. And those three sources are just the beginning of our fertilization program here. And actually, the ground is not very good in quality, so we have to build the soil and we have to provide a lot of organic matter and also the organic fertilizers I mentioned to get it up to production capacity. But things are going great. So far we have really moved forward in all of those things. I want this place to be not only productive and clean and healthy, providing great produce and food for the local community, but also a beautiful space that people feel relaxed, feel close to nature. And we're working on that little by little. We have our obviously our production animals. We have 89 chickens, laying hens, and we have 3 turkeys. These are the species that were around during the Aztec times, so it's a heritage breed, you could say. And we also have ducks, and so the ducks are just for fun, but everyone loves to see them. And maybe someday we'll have some duck eggs or some baby ducks from them. Little by little, we're making space greener. We're making it more productive. We're cleaning up the mess that was here. And hopefully we will have not only a productive space, but a beautiful space, and one that provides enough income to pay the bills. Just recently we had our inauguration ceremony where we introduced our project to the world, as it were. We invited our closest friends, family members, and people who have worked on the project, and it was incredibly well received. Everybody was excited about the project.
Perdón.
and I can't wait to get moving to the next step and building this place up even further. We're off to a great start. There was a lot of interest in our products, and hopefully we can spread the word and build a network in Chimalhuacan for people who appreciate organic and locally produced produce. And then we can be one of the most important players in that space. El Huerto Evergreen is all about respecting the past, even bringing the past back to life, while also embracing the future, which is better management practices, better use of resources, and the best possible production of produce that we can have. So this has been a really exciting project to work on because we have so many different elements, but the philosophy is always been the same, that we want to have high quality, healthy produce available to the local community, and especially to be an example to other producers of the path forward, that it respects our bodies, respects the earth, but still is profitable enough that we can live comfortable lives. So I hope that we can achieve all of that and more in the coming months and years as we continue to develop the project. My motivation for being here is that makes me excited to come here every day, is that we live in a city that is overpopulated, is overpolluted, is definitely not what it used to be 100 years ago by any means. And when I come here, I can see a little piece of the past, and also I hope the future. And I want that to be a model for the rest of the community, and hopefully everyone else can enjoy it as much as I do.